Good morning, students. Yesterday we have discussed about the formation of ASEAN and its objective. Now, one word is written here, you can see ASEAN Way. What was ASEAN Way? ASEAN Way was a form of interaction among all those 10 countries. That is informal. What type of interaction? Informal interaction and non-confrontational and cooperative. Now, students, the interaction among all those countries, how many countries? 10, yes. The interaction among these 10 countries was informal and they were cooperating with each other. This was known as ASEAN Way, and this speciality, this feature of ASEAN Way makes ASEAN different from European Union. Although the countries of European Union were cooperative with each other, but their relations were, their interaction was not so informal. And one more thing, one more difference between ASEAN and European Union is that European Union tried to be supranational. Supranational means above the nations. I have discussed when I have taught you about European Union, that European Union tried to be above the nation, supranational. It tried to form its constitution and it is having its own flag, it is having its currency also. But ASEAN never tried to be supranational. It has given respect to the sovereignty of each country. They are not having common currency. Although ASEAN is having its flag as European Union. So these three points you can write in the answer how the ASEAN is different from European Union. You will write the definition of ASEAN Way, then you will write that it didn't become supranational, and third, respect for national sovereignty. I was telling you that ASEAN is having its flag and the logo of ASEAN is having 10 stalks of paddy. Paddy, you know, rice. Why 10? Because the number of member countries of ASEAN is 10. And these 10 countries of Southeast Asia, they are bound with each other. They are friends. They are having the feeling of solidarity. Clear? And in that flag, there is a circle. And that circle shows that all the countries of ASEAN, they are one. They are united with each other. Although they are having their own sovereignty, but they are united. Students, as I have told you, its objective, that was economic acceleration, social and cultural, but with the course of time, it has broadened its objective beyond social and economic. And in 2003, ASEAN has established three pillars, three groups. Three communities were established by ASEAN, and these were known as three pillars. The first pillar of ASEAN is ASEAN Security Community. As it's clear from its name that this community, this pillar was formed to keep peace among all the 10 nations of ASEAN. What is its objective? That no armed confrontation will be there between any two or among all these 10 nations. No wars will be there. And any agreement for peace, cooperation, neutrality, non-interference and respect of sovereign rights, all these agreements were signed. Many agreements. They have signed many agreements for peace, for cooperation, for neutrality, for non-interfering in the internal matters of each other, and they have also signed agreement to respect the sovereignty of each other. And in 1994, these ASEAN countries has formed a forum that was known as ARF, ASEAN Regional Forum, in 1994. Why it was formed? It was formed to coordinate security and foreign policy. Means the foreign policy of these countries, they must discuss when they are going to form the objectives or the principles of their foreign policy. So this was ASEAN Security Community. So students, that's all for today. Tomorrow we will meet again with the second pillar of ASEAN.